great question. You know, we don't talk to the whales like you and I talk to each other. However, we have developed a unique system of signals that better help us communicate with our whales. For example, when the trainer is bending the waist, the whales know to move their head in an up and down motion. The whales can even do mimic behaviors when they mimic their trainers. So when Sean canvas put one hand up in the air, the whales will actually mimic that behavior, raising their front arm over and out of the water. We give you a great big wave hello. Everybody wave hello to how you get to our. You know, because of this ongoing communication, we're able to develop unique and strong relationships with all of our animals. And it's because of these relationships, we can do important things like answer scientific questions through research.
Here at SeaWorld, we have a unique opportunity to conduct research about killer whales, asking important questions that can only be answered in a setting like this.
Recently, right here at SeaWorld San Antonio, we conducted groundbreaking research on killer whales' hearing ability. Kaiyuki and Tuar actually participated in a two-year-long hearing study. We devised a hearing test very similar to a hearing test you or I might take at the doctor's office. We were able to compile all of this data and find out that killer whales have an incredible range of hearing, even at frequencies much higher than we can detect. Policy and lawmakers can take all of this information to help enact laws to better help protect whales and dolphins in their ocean home from noise pollution that's associated with boat traffic.
So much of what we're learning is being used to help killer whales in the wild. Of course, there are other questions that can only be explored by studying whales in the ocean. By exploring questions both at SeaWorld and in the wild, our combined research gives all of us a better understanding of killer whales and the places they live.
And that's what I call working together. Research going in both directions, from our part to the wild and then back again. That way everyone benefits. Wow, that is a lot of questions, and believe it or not, we get them every day.
We sure do, and to answer those questions, our whales talk to each other by making different sounds or vocalizations. Let's take a listen to hear some of the sounds Kaiyuki and Tuar can make.
Thank you.
you guys. We call this behavior a hula. All right, Piper and Gavin, for this last behavior, we're going to do that special hand signal I taught you guys right before the show. So whenever you're ready, stick your hands out straight in front of you, and on the count of three, throw them over your head. 1, 2, 3! Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget Shannon and Peter, it is a 24-hour splash show. Piper and Gavin, thank you so much for your help today. We want to give you these special whale tail necklaces to remember meeting Kaiki the dance you are today. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for our special guests.
Behaviors you'll see animals you hear at Serum and in the ocean.